Hey, what's up guys, Thrall here, back with another exciting Photoshop tutorial. And in today's tutorial we are going to create everyone's favorite soft light effect, which makes images look really beautiful when it's done properly. So let's get started. Okay, so I have my image already open in Photoshop, and if you want you can go to file and open any image you want. I don't like the proportion of this image, so I'm just gonna crop it a bit from top and bottom. We are just basically creating a mid shot instead of a full shot. And after that, hit enter to confirm your selection and select your move tool. For the first step, I will go, as you can see here, options. I'm going to create a new adjustment layer of curves. And in the curves, try to make a shape that looks something like this. Lift this point from here, so it will lighten the shadows, and also this from. So this dot will basically brighten the highlights a little more, and drag it down also a bit to create a slight contrast. Don't make it real crazy, and try to make a shape that looks something like this. You do not need to follow this exactly. And then go to red, create three dots like this. This process is called as cross processing, which basically adds opposite colors to shadows and highlights, so it creates a really good looking color effect which everyone loves. So try to make it a little high, not too extreme, and this one little down. Don't concentrate on your curves while adjusting this, concentrate on your image, so it will help while, you know, deciding what amount of color you need. And after that, let's move to greens and do the same thing with that. Again, create three dots like this and make a slight S shape. Don't go extreme in this too either. Look at your picture and analyze what type of color and amount you need. So this is a pretty easy thing to follow. Just create three dots and make cross process. And after that, go to blue. And this time we are not going to create a middle dot, only two dots like this. And after that, turn down, this time not S, this time opposite of S. What I'm basically doing is adding some yellows in the highlights and some blues in the shadows, so it will create some type of cross processing thing. Just play with it until you are satisfied with your image. And I will drag this slider from here also a bit. So that looks pretty fine, maybe a little extreme, but just play with it until you're happy. So as you can see, it has created a bit of contrasty look, and I want a little less contrast, so I will drag it up even more like this, and from here something like this. Okay, this looks perfect. We are done with the curves. Now I'm going to create another adjustment layer, which is a solid color. And in the color code, I am using 18182D, basically a dark desaturated bluish type tone, and hit OK. Put this on a exclusion mode. Where is it? Here, exclusion mode. So basically what this doing is adding some light parts in the shadow, so image is looking a little flat type. So here it is. And after that, create one more adjustment layer, which is, where are you, photo filter. And the photo filter, I was just playing with it and found the default one works great for this image. So I just used the default color gradient, this one here, and adjusted the value to 30. That looks good. I think I will turn down curves power a little less, maybe. Okay, now this looks better. So this was our starting image, and here we are right now. So we are basically done with the basic color adjustment, and now the time of that dreamy orange light that comes from certain angle of the image that makes it a whole lot better, and that is really easy to create. But first off, I forgot one step. Yeah, the brightness thing. I'm gonna add some little contrast and brightness kind of a lot. But don't worry about that. Once you are done with the brightness, select your mask and press Ctrl I. And after that, make sure you have selected a brush tool, right click, come on, huh? And after that, a ridiculously big brush that is apparently this size big and hardness 0%, and do a single click on this part. So it looks like a light coming from that angle. See, it's really easy to create. I mean, we are done with that. And after that, create a blank layer. Make sure brush tool is already selected. And in the color, first of all, a orange, a dark orange, which is a little reddish. I don't know what to call this type of colors, but you can see on screen it looks something like this. And start painting again. See, it looks terrible right now, no? But when you put the blending mode on screen, it's much better. Actually, not that better, sorry. Where are you, screen? Here, again. Okay, now you can paint a little more if you want, and it looks fine. And if you find the effect okay, but it's a little strong, just go and turn down the opacity a bit. So, see, it's easy. And after that, create another layer, and this time cyan color, because I love that color. It looks really good in images, you know. And after that, click again and again, put it on a screen mode. Not a huge change, so I will have to turn down opacity a lot this time, but it's working pretty good. See, nice. So we are pretty much done with the image, but if you want some further changes, like the image itself was already a lot of washed out type, I mean, it's dull image, so you can create a vibrance layer. Where are you? Yes, to add some colors to it before starting, let me show you, and then apply all the process so it will look a little better. And after that, so we are basically done with it, and I can create one more vibrance layer to add some color to overall image. That also looks really good. So the final image is ready and it is looking really beautiful. You can also see some after before here. If you like my videos, feel free to give it a thumbs up. You can also subscribe to my channel for future updates. Thanks for watching and supporting, guys. Take care, goodbye, have some fun with Photoshop.